This video will present Mendel's laws of segregation and independent assortment. There are two terms that must be defined to understand how the transmission of genetic information takes place. The first is phenotype. A phenotype is an organism's observable characteristics. It is a visible, measurable property, for example, the color of your eyes. The second is genotype, which is the set of alleles possessed by an organism. This is the underlying genetic makeup that we can infer from the phenotype, and is responsible for creating the observable phenotype. One of the first analyses of genetic transmission was done in the 19th century by Gregor Mendel, who established two laws, the law of segregation and the law of independent assortment. Let's begin with the law of segregation. This law relies on Mendel's realization that each trait he studied was governed by a pair of factors. We now know these factors as alleles. Some traits can result in different phenotypes depending on the composition of alleles, and a phenotype for a given trait can be dominant over another phenotype for the same trait. Mendel studied the transmission of traits in pea plants. He used pea plants because true breeding plants can, through self-pollination, yield offspring with identical phenotypes to the parent. Pea plants can also cross-pollinate between true breeding parents. Mendel used these methods of pollination to study the transmission of inherited traits. Let's look at a very simple experiment that Mendel did with these pea plants. Mendel studied a trait that is related to the shape of peas. He found that peas that were produced by certain plants could either be smooth or wrinkled. The experiment began with true breeding parents. One of the parents had smooth peas. This indicates that, being a true breeding organism, both alleles must be identical. They are denoted as two uppercase R's. Consequently, this organism would generate gametes that carry the uppercase R allele. The other true breeding parent also had two identical alleles, but these were different from the other parent. Each allele is denoted as a lowercase r. This parent would produce gametes that carry the lowercase r allele. We refer to the state of having two identical alleles as homozygous. Through cross-pollination, Mendel generated the first filial generation, known as the F1 generation. He observed that all plants in the F1 generation displayed the same phenotype, smooth peas. This can be explained by these plants being heterozygous. They carried an uppercase R allele and one lowercase R allele. And the smooth phenotype, uppercase R, is dominant over the wrinkled phenotype, lowercase r. In this case, plants from the F1 generation all contain a combination of uppercase R from one parent and lowercase r from the other parent, and must produce smooth peas. These F1 plants were capable of producing two types of gametes, one containing the uppercase R allele and the other containing the lowercase R allele. Mendel produced a second filial generation, denoted as F2, by cross-pollinating plants from the F1 generation. He consistently found two phenotypes, smooth and wrinkled, in a ratio close to three smooth peas for one wrinkled pea. This ratio can be explained by the production of four possible combinations of allele: uppercase R and uppercase R, uppercase R and lowercase R and uppercase R, both referred to as heterozygous big R little r, and lowercase r and lowercase r. Based on the known dominance of uppercase R over lowercase r, the first three combinations must produce smooth peas, and the last combination must produce wrinkled peas. This interpretation implies that each allele, whether uppercase R or lowercase r, segregates independently during the formation of gametes. The full set of Mendel's experiments included self-pollination of all the progeny obtained in F2 to get the F3 generation. The results were the following. All the F2 peas with recessive traits, wrinkled, produced only F3 peas with the recessive traits, and the peas with the dominant trait, smooth, produced F3 progeny that was divided into two groups. One-third produced peas with the only dominant trait, smooth, and two-thirds produced a mixed progeny with the previously observed 3-to-1 ratio of dominant to recessive. The analysis of the phenotypic ratio in the F3 generation confirms the independent segregation of alleles, allowing Mendel to postulate his first law, the law of segregation. Two alleles governing a trait segregate independently into separate gametes, and each progeny inherits one allele from each parent. Now the question is, what happens if we study more than one trait? Do these traits sort independently of each other? To address this question, Mendel set up an experiment to study the assortment of two traits. He once again used pea plants, and he looked at the shape of the peas, either smooth or wrinkled, and the color of the peas, either green or yellow. Here, the color is represented by either an uppercase or lowercase y, and the shape of the pea is represented by an uppercase or lowercase r. In this case, one of the true breeding parents produces smooth and yellow peas, uppercase r and uppercase r, and uppercase y and uppercase y. The other true breeding parent produces wrinkled and green peas, lowercase r, and lowercase y and lowercase y. The F1 generation is produced from a cross-pollination of these true breeding pea plants, and the F1 plants all have the same phenotype, smooth and yellow peas. This shows that these two traits are dominant. We can expect that F2 plants produce four types of gametes containing different combinations of alleles: uppercase R and uppercase Y, uppercase R and lowercase Y, lowercase R and uppercase Y, and finally lowercase R and lowercase Y. Four distinct phenotypes are observed in the F2 generation: two parental phenotypes, smooth yellow peas and wrinkled green peas, and two recombinant phenotypes with characteristics from both parents, smooth green peas and wrinkled yellow peas. The ratio of these phenotypes is 9 to 3 to 3 to 1. 9 plants produced smooth and yellow peas, 3 plants produced recombinant smooth and green peas, 3 plants produced recombinant wrinkled and yellow peas, and 1 plant produced wrinkled and green peas. This ratio is explained by the dominance of smooth and yellow over wrinkled and green, and an independent assortment of traits, which is when the shape and the color assort independently of each other. This led to Mendel's second law, the law of independent assortment. Mendel's law of independent assortment states that the alleles of two or more different unlinked genes get sorted into gametes independently of one another. In conclusion, traits are transmitted predictably in simple cases, governed by principles such as dominance. Mendel's laws of independent assortment emphasize segregation and independent assortment during gamete formation. Mendel's laws provide a foundational but limited understanding of genetic inheritance, primarily applicable under specific conditions, showing the systematic nature of inheritance. However, they only apply to single gene phenotypes and unlinked genes. Mendel's laws cannot predict phenotypic changes caused by mutations or the inheritance of traits that are controlled by more than one gene.